ready to go. Zora giving the all clear.
Give him the honorary fist bumps.
Absolutely.
All right, game two.
Brandon dropping that hot intro.
Yeah.
Shout out to the man in the chair, the god, Brandon. Like, I shout him out every single time we're at a big event, and that's because literally none of these would work without him.
Yes.
Like,
shout out to TOs and just everyone behind the scenes, because this would not be
those
as beautiful.
Bubble, and that's how, ooh, I don't even know what happened.
I don't know either.
That's the downside to Raster in doubles, is like, if you get caught bad DIing something, you can just explode. And
yeah, especially in doubles. You just kind of die and you get lost in the timeline.
And that, again, that vertical kill power from Capscott, he's been throwing out up smashes, because if one of them lands it at 100, at 200, or at, even at 80, that up smash will kill.
Yeah. Steph barely missing his parry punish, but Capscott being able to finish up those stocks.
And red team just living through, both at 100%, so both definitely well within kill percent.
Yeah, and both are up one stock. That being said, clearing an F smash gets better burn. Ooh, Tapscott taking the wood stock.
Down tilt to up air. Not necessarily port. Oh, is he? No, I love that. I love that so much.
Yeah.
So the bubble butt into immediate Orca Hop. Not a recovery I'm used to seeing, actually. I'm going to steal that.
Yeah, Tapscott's recovery is very, very nutty. Any Orcane should definitely take notes on him.
Anytime I see a recovery that I've not used before, I immediately add it to my notebook.
Oh, yeah. The mental notebook or even physical notebook.
Up smash! No! I was expecting a...
Ooh, try to get Gatling.
That was a very vulnerable chef for a moment. Oh, my
ooh.
God.
Oh, Tapscott trying to kill him.
Junna going high. That's the Junna I know and love. He will go for that. Fall down. Ooh. Tapscott.
Nice berry down smash.
Perhaps accidentally, perhaps intentionally saving Tapscott with that. Just threatened down smash.
Yeah. So 2v1. Both two stocks. Yep. This two that be very, very scary.
High percent on the Zetterburn, but with a full stock to go on top of it.
Yeah.
This is looking like we're going for game two.
Yeah. Which, you know,
well, let's see what Chef can do, right? Like, let's not count out the boy yet, because it's Clarence, so you always have to just have just a level of respect. That's a 192 on that.
Yeah, yeah. Croc's living really long.
That's potentially big. Because, okay. That's huge! Okay, never mind. All right. Throws another stock. Okay.
Nice parry on down smash.
I forgot that they both had two stocks.
Yeah.
All right, yeah, no. This is...
But, you know, game one is learning your partner, learning how both of you guys play. We should see a bigger and better improved blue team next game.
And trying to get that ledge cancel in there at the end to
yes.
just give him that option. If he had landed flat on stage, he was eating a forward smash and up smash.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah.
And Chef pulling out the Zetterburn. Junna pulling out the Crag. I agree with the Crag switch. The Claren at the end there was looking very clean, but at this point, I know Chef's Zetterburn has been devastating here.
For sure. Yeah.
So I agree with the entire team switch.
Yeah, and Zetterburn is also just a very, very good pick in doubles as well.
Yeah.
Junna, you know, he's going to live a lot longer now that he's Crag. He's not going to die randomly off the top.
I also think that Junna's going to find more success finding those kill confirms, because he was going for a lot of claps, but he wasn't finding them with the Raster. He was going for
right.
all the stomps off
yeah.
stage, things like that, and it just wasn't working out. Meanwhile, Rock? Orcane, no like Rock.
Yes.
Rock. It bad. Rock bad.
Okay,
so,
a little love from the Jeff team. Who's on commentary? DC2 Poke and Breadstick.
Nice to meet you all.
Also, welcome Dima and everyone else in chat.
We love you, chat.
Hell yeah.
I was going to say we wouldn't be here without you, but we wouldn't have as many great friends as we do. We wouldn't have the connection that we have if it wasn't for you guys.
For sure, the community.
We would still be here, though.
No.
We love this game. Oh, I love that intro. Oh, that's so nice.
Nice Crag intro as well. So early percent lead from Red Team, but
Junna
that doesn't mean anything.
Junna just wants to land.
Yeah.
Junna has been in hit stun I think since the game's inception. There we go. And I think the person to keep your eye on is actually Chef. He's going to be electing not. Okay, so Tapscott edgeguarding. Double edgeguard on opposite side of the stage. Just.
Ooh, that could have been very scary from Tapscott. Ooh, gets a down smash. First kill of the game.
Yep. Junna just got. He just never got any sort of stage presence, any sort of stage control. Oh, run off in air. Good DI from Pro. Way out there.
Ooh, nice
there.
Crack.
And that's what I was talking about for that kills. It's
yes,
so much easier for Junna just to land a fair on someone at like 100%, 120% when they're off stage than it is for him to land a clap with Rastin.
For sure. That being said, red team does have control of center stage. Let's see if Junna can get
down smash.
Yep, very down smash.
Good. I was going to say, good DI for Tapscott. Just barely killing off the side there. Junna rolling back to stage.
Craig interrupting Red Team's little combo that they had going.
There's some slick team combos from Red Team.
Yeah, there really is.
There's some. They're flowing into each other pretty well. Oh, it doesn't get them off its combo. Down air, jump smash.
Ooh, but nair up smash from Throx.
There was
very, very reliable kill.
So much hit stun on that poor Craig. He was at like 190. He was not coming down. Oh!
Double down B. All right.
Junna ran away with that rock to set that up.
Yeah, he did.
Oh, Junna might be in trouble.
Let's see if Chef can help him out.
Chef landing an unfortunate dash tag. Fair, not going to kill.
Ooh,
and unfortunately, it's itself for Pro. This is looking kind of difficult.
Yeah.
Again, both of them, like, this is still doable. A quick, like, that could have been a parry into, like, a down smash to get a stock. And then maybe, like, a quick execute. Chef can absolutely do this.
Oh, okay.
That's
double
two.
Double kill with a down smash.
Woo! Did you see that edge control?
Dude, yes, very smoothing.
I'm psyched to see Chef like do what he can. He's got to be so careful. And while difficult, not impossible.
Very good smash. It's very well doable.
I've seen Chef kill at like zero.
That being said, he gets caught with his roll, gets down smash,
burning down smash.
Yep.
That's a lot of down smashes that are going to